When we check in this step, if the blade is not okay, break the blade to check the blade. If it is not okay, we must, if we replace a new blade or there is an error in the blade, we must do the setup for the blade. When we break the setup for the blade, we find that there are three types of setup. Contact type setup, and sensor calibration, and non-contact type setup. There are three different setups. The first one is the contact setup. The blade go down to touch the chuck by means of electric conduction to check the upper surface of the chuck. But at this setup, we must remove any water, we must close the water, and also remove any workpiece from the upper surface of the chuck. It must be cleaned without any workpiece or water to check the chuck upper surface. The next setup is sensor calibration. Before sensor calibration, we go to the non-contact setup. For the non-contact setup, the sensor, there are a sensor. We can see the sensor in the rear end of the chuck. there are two lines of water in the rear end. After removing the chuck to the upper surface, we can see that. We should remove this direction. You can see this is the sensor. This is the sensor. This is the non-contact sensor. Is used to check the blade edge with the chuck table, but without contact, by visually inspection. This is the optical sensor to check the level of the blade relative to the upper surface of the chuck table. The last type of setup for the blade, if we replace a chuck by a new chuck and set it on the machine, we must calibrate the sensor, because the sensor measures the edge of the blade relative to the upper surface of the chuck. For the new chuck, the sensor must be calibrated to check the upper surface of the new chuck. So the setup sensor calibration must be done before the non-contact setup if we replace the chuck by a new chuck. If we new replace a new blade, we must do all these setups. Any setup we push here for the setup, and there is a start. The setup will start. After finishing the stop, we can find here a message that the stop is completed correctly. Then go to the next setup and second setup. After finishing these steps, we must adjust the hairline cutting of the of the new blade. For the new blade, it have a thickness of the blade. The thickness of the blade when cut on the workpiece, there is a width of cut. We can adjust the hairline start and end for the dash lines in the microscope with the width of the cut that is done by the new blade. It must be done when we replace a new blade.